aus den USA, der Harlem Hammer, James Butler.
So there's our MC then, Lars Riedel, celebrity MC, announcing the challenger for the IBF super middleweight title from Harlem, New York, James Butler. And Butler, well, he's only been beaten once in 19 starts. He's won 18 and stopped a dozen. Made two defenses of his USBA championship in the super middleweight division. And here he is challenging for the IBF title. But, you know, I've got to wonder really what the IBF are playing at, because Sven Ottke, you know, one or two reasonably demanding defenses, but he can fight anyone he likes. The IBF will sanction almost any fight that Ottke wants. As long as the promoters keep paying the sanction fees, they'll let him fight who he likes by the look of things. It's one of those odd situations that's arisen, of course, because there's so many sanctioning bodies. The quality is so diluted now, it's ridiculous. You'd go looking well outside the top 20, well outside the top 100 on occasion to find the next available challenger. Butler fits the bill. Been a pro since 1996. And his only defeat so far was in his third pro fight. He was outpointed over four rounds. So fairly meaningless loss that way back now in 1997. Ottke, of course, unbeaten in 23 professional fights. So there he is then, the man from Harlem. In New York, James Butler, 28 years of age, and a former USBA champion. And that, of course, is the American title, or at least one half of the American title, the other half being the United States Boxing Federation Championship. Oh, of course, there's another one now, isn't there? The North American Boxing Organization. And here comes the champion then, 11th defense of the IBF super middleweight crown for the German from Berlin, Sven Ottke. 23 fights, 23 wins, but only 4 knockouts. But that doesn't tell the whole story. He's very cute and he's very efficient. He's so far done everything that's been asked of him. You may remember he beat Charles Brewer on points over 12 rounds. A fairly close fight, but a genuine winner to win the title. And in his 7th defense, he put any doubts about Brewer being unlucky by beating Brewer again on points. Most demanding fight he's had so far was with Lloyd Bryan, the Jamaican. Halfway through his reign, he fought Lloyd Bryan, and I think he did exceptionally well to win by a single point. Very close fight. Bryan won 5 of the last 6 rounds. Interesting match. Last time. In fact, we've shown virtually every one of Sven Ottke's fights so far here on British Eurosport. Former Olympian, of course, and German champion, and world title contender in the amateur ranks. The only problem, of course, is Ottke is now 34 years of age, and there's going to come a time when Father Time knocks on his door and says, "That's your lot, Sven. Time to go." And, of course, fighters of a certain age can fall apart overnight. And once again, showers of silver foil come sprinkling down from the ceiling. And it really does get everywhere, this silver foil, by the way. And you wonder if it touches anything electrical, if you're going to get a problem. It sticks to absolutely everything. It seems to be statically charged. There's no doubt about it, though. Ottke is one of the best super middleweights in the world. I've had a few emails from people who've said, "Hey, what are you saying? Joe Calzaghe is the man." Well, let's see. It'll never happen, of course. Ottke will never fight Calzaghe and vice versa, and that's a real shame. It's one of the problems with professional boxing today. But if they did fight, it would be an interesting match. And a lot closer than a lot of people think. So there he is then, the IBF super middleweight champion, Sven Ottke. Of course, the dream match for German fight fans will never happen now. He could have fought Marcus Beyer when Beyer was WBC champion to unify the titles. It would have been worth a fortune in Germany, but of course Beyer got himself knocked out by Glenn Catley. And then formalities completed. And that referee, Randy Newman, by the way, former heavyweight himself, the referee.
In der roten Ecke, der Herausforderer James Butler, 28 Jahre alt, 76 Kilo schwer. Misst 1,83. Sein Profidebüt gab 1996. Ich bin 19 Kämpfe, gewann 18 und 12 davon durch K.O. James Butler! In der blauen Ecke, der Weltmeister, Sven Ottke. Seitdem blieb in all seinen 23 Kämpfen siegreich. Viermal gewann durch K.O. Sven Ottke!
So here we go then for the IBF Super Middleweight Championship. Sven Ottke, the champion from Germany, making the 11th defense of the title against the New Yorker, James Butler. 18 wins, 1 defeat, 12 knockouts for Butler. But Ottke undefeated in 23 starts, 4 knockouts to his credit. 12 three-minute rounds potentially in front of us. And Ottke is a pretty decent fighter, no doubt about that. But you're going to wonder, at 34 years of age, 6 years older than Butler, when will Father Time come knocking on his door to remind him that it's all over? Let's just see how this one starts. Of course, the beginning is very, very important in a fight. You've got to be the boss early on and show your opponent exactly what he can and can't get away with. As you can see, Butler is slightly bigger than Ottke. He's got that wild look about him. And Ottke is very, very hard to nail, with more than one clean punch at a time. He'll tie you up, he'll use his footwork. He's very canny in defense. Another thing is, he's got very quick hands as well. He closes the gap nicely. And you might think you're in the clear, that all of a sudden, he's punching you. And the crowd absolutely adore Ottke. And by the way, referee Randy Newman, as Ottke lands a combination there, once fought Billy Aird, who's also a referee in Britain these days. I wonder if they'll get it on again. And one thing Ottke can do for 12 rounds is concentrate. He never loses sight of what his job is. And of course, his job is to retain his championship. And he does it with, most of the time, with consummate ease. But of course, he had that real, real fright when he fought Lloyd Bryan and won by the narrowest of margins. As you can see here, Butler has got reasonably long arms, but of course he's got to keep them pumping to be worth anything at all. Well, not a bad start there from both men, to be honest with you, but I've got a feeling Ottke has just nicked that first round.
Ich habe sie sehen. Pass auf. Gut, muss aufpassen, dass die Rechte nicht hinterher kommen. Ne? Ist gut so.
So, long time coach on the amateur ranks, Uli Wegner. And of course, Denny Mancini once again working as the cuts man. I believe he's only ever been required on two occasions, Denny, because you can never legislate for cuts. You've got to ensure that the right man is in place if and when it happens. And as I've said, Denny is one of the most renowned cutsmen in the world of professional boxing. Into the second then. So, Sven Ottke, once he gets a look at you, he's worked you out in 3 minutes. And that's how quickly he can do it, you know. Some fighters take a few rounds, not Ottke. He's there, he susses you out in the very, very beginning. Takes a big right there from Butler. but it might be the only right that Butler lands in this fight. As I say, Ottke really does work you out very, very early, and he minimizes the risk. And Ottke really is the thinking man's fighter, no doubt about that. It might not be the most exciting fighter you've ever seen, and never has the most exciting fight you'll ever see, but he's a very good technician. And shows, of course, the importance of speed of punch. Can never be exaggerated. And Ottke's footwork is also a joy to watch. He rarely gets anything wrong foot-wise. He keeps that lovely, steady, balanced base. And it really is the blocks on which his style is built. Just have a look at his feet for a moment. Forget his hands. He's ready to go in, out, left or right. And maintain that crucial gap between the feet to keep the balance right. And Butler beginning to realise what a difficult job he's got in his hands here, especially in Germany, against the champion. There's no doubt about it that Ottke has earned the respect of the boxing world, I think, with his dominance, really, of this IBF championship. As I say, I don't think the IBF have really tested him too much, and they seem to be reasonably obliging with opponents. But that's not their fault, and it's not necessarily anyone's fault, really. It's just who's available. And Ottke's dealt with them all so far. And that's another good round for Sven Ottke. So winning very comfortably at the moment, 20-18.
Spacious. Luxurious. Welcome to the essence of contemporary minivan, Kia Sedona. All you need to do is to enjoy yourself. Surprise yourself with Kia Sedona. Kia Motors.
So round three then coming up, and this good crowd in Magdeburg, as I say, they know their boxing. Cheering on the local here, well, not local, just a couple of hours, of course, north-east for Ottke to get back to Berlin. But here he is in action against James Butler from New York, the Harlem district, of course. Pretty tough neighbourhood. But I'll tell you something, he's in a tougher neighbourhood now, trying to win a world title off a German in Germany with 10,000 rabid fans. Couldn't get much tougher. Only slightly surprised that the Germans have actually accepted the referee Randy Newman being an American. Randy Newman, of course, was also a singer, not the same guy. Once again, small but scoring punches from Ottke. And if you're wondering what that is on Ottke's back, it's his idea of promoting safe sex. And rightly so, the message does get through. Lots of people talk about the stencil he has on his back. It's not a tattoo, but he does it for every fight. Nice speed here from both men. Real chess match this one. And just when you think you've worked Ottke out, suddenly he'll change tack and you'll have to start again. And by the time you work him out once more, he'll be two or three rounds in front of you. I'm not, by the way, the leader of the Sven Ottke fan club, but I do appreciate his ability and his skill and his approach. Butler once again there suckered by a three-punch combination. And because you really can't anticipate Ottke, you can't really have an answer for anything he does. Very, very effective. So there you are then, another round for Sven Ottke. So that makes it 30-27 on my scorecard. As Randy Newman goes round to the individual judges, picks up their scorecards, gives them to the main adjudicator, the supervisor, who will keep a running record of the scores. And I just wonder how long Ottke intends to continue. He's one of those men that you'd imagine would know when it was time to hang up the gloves. But then again, they never do, really, do they? They always seem to run into trouble. And Ottke will probably be no exception. Although, it'd be great to see a champion retire undefeated. Against the Butlers of this world, that might be possible, but we probably haven't yet seen the best of James Butler, as we've come out now for round four. Ottke, by the way, turned professional after the 1996 Olympic Games in Atlanta. And all but one of his fights so far have taken place in Germany. He once fought Roman Babayev in Austria. But since then, it's always been on German soil, either in Halle, Berlin, or here in Magdeburg. And once again, excellent timing by Ottke. Okay, maybe not what it was. You know, we all get blunted in various aspects over the years, but his timing's still pretty good. He knows when to pounce. Doesn't pounce quite as often as he used to. A little short left hook there from Ottke. And once again, wild attack here from Butler. Getting frustrated now, I would imagine. And he really couldn't hit Ottke with a bag of sand, could he? And you may be able to see there that Otka's got a bit of the silver foil that fluttered down from the ceiling on his waist, just above his waistband there. As I say, it does seem to... Oh, nice work from Ottke. Best three punches of the fight so far. Yes, the silver foil does develop very sticky static. Hard to get off at times. Once again, Butler wild with his attack. just hoping that something will get through and make a difference. Crowd very noisy on occasion here. And once again, Butler forced back. Yes, I thought I heard the bell as well. Yes, I did. Well, there you are. Bit of overtime there for these two. But no doubt about the winner of the round. And the further this one goes, the further Ottke wins the rounds by. So a pulsating atmosphere. Once again, Ottke in replay, scoring nicely. See, no answer. Four punches there landed. And although Butler might well have seen them coming, just could not avoid them. It's round five of this scheduled 12. And the rounds are zipping by. And that's always a good sign. Ottke nullifies you in the, well, he works you out in the beginning, then he starts to nullify your strengths, and then he really exploits your weaknesses, and that's exactly what that stage he's got to here. And the further it goes, I've got a feeling the further Ottke will win by. Still a master of tactics. And it really is probably a natural gift to be able to fight the way he does. As I say, he's not exciting, that we know. But he's very, very efficient. I'd be fascinated to see how we get on with Joe Calzaghe. Joe, of course, is the big puncher. And once again, decent work from Sven Ottke. One thing I suppose against Ottke in a match with Calzaghe is that Sven is not used to taking a hard punch, that's for certain. And it's guaranteed that Joe Calzaghe will bang him hard if he gets the opportunity. But anyway, it's all speculation. As I say, it'll never happen. Politics. Long left hook there from Butler, but Ottke caught it on his glove and again. Oh, now a switch to southpaw from Butler for just a second. And that confused Sven Ottke, but he's back in charge. And once again, a wild attack here from Butler. Knows he's got to do something. But once again, Ottke really pays him back. Beautiful. And then just when Butler felt like having a go, Ottke got him close, held hold of him, and the moment had gone. So Butler's got to reset himself. And Ottke won't let him as the bell ends round five, and another big round there for Sven Ottke. And I've said this time and again, and I can hear myself saying it once more, you know, he's tamed the challenger. And he's so good at that. But Ottke there allowing himself a little smile as he sits on that stool. Just trying to think what that says. The rest of the world was included, whatever it said. There's a lovely combination again from Ottke on replay. And that's a very unusual combination there. 8 punches by Ottke. Very unusual to see him do that. As we come out for round 6 now. And his IBF super middleweight crown looks very, very firmly on the head of Sven Ottke. And there's going to have to be something almightily special from James Butler if he's going to dislodge that crown and take it home back to New York with him. And again, a short, sharp shot from Ottke. And you've really got to have seen Ottke from the beginning, really, to appreciate his ability and how he's grown into his style and his reign as champion. The casual viewer probably doesn't appreciate Ottke quite as much as those that have followed him through history. Let's say we've featured him here on Eurosport since 1997. I think we've done every single one of his fights. Again, nice work there from Sven. Never overcommits himself. Always has his feet just right. I don't think he's been down so far in his professional career. In fact, I'm certain he hasn't, as once again Butler tries his luck as a southpaw. But of course, Ottke, so used to sparring with southpaws, it won't make any difference. There's probably more southpaws in Germany per square inch than anywhere else in the world. And they've not got a massive boxing population, but they've got a lot of southpaws. Bit of swelling now around the left eye, just below the left eye of Butler. Butler must be wondering what on earth is happening here. He can see Ottke in front of him. He's there to be hit. But Butler is not getting the success he might have hoped for. And then all of a sudden, he's getting clouted and he's wondering what's going on. Oh, and there's a bit of damage now around Ottke's right eye. I don't think it's a cut, more like a mouse. In fact, it's bigger than that. It's more like a rat. As Ottke wins the 6th. Well, the Harlem Hammer, if ever he needed it, it's now. Nosebleed and that swelling, of course, underneath that left eye. Nosebleed is absolutely nothing in boxing terms. It's the least you can expect when you pop into a boxing ring.
You ain't gonna win the fight throwing one punch at a guy. Forget about him. You'll knock this guy with combinations, man. You punch too hard.
Hey, Bobby, we got to win by knockout. We got to win. You got it, right?
Combination.
Throw combination.
Punch when this guy's coming in for you. Punch when he's coming in for you.
That gentleman now talking was, of course, in Henry Akinwunder's corner of the night. Akinwunder fought Lennox Lewis. So here we go then for the halfway point, round 7. And I don't think Don Turner's advice is going to make the slightest bit of difference. It's his only combinations to knock this guy out. But as I said before, very rare to be able to catch Ottke with more than one single punch at a time. So forget combinations. Try for the big single shot. 12 knockouts, of course, in 18 wins on the Butler record. But to be honest with you, there's no names to conjure with at all. Bryant Brannan was about the only one, and Butler beat Brannan in 7 to become USBA champion. But by that time, Brannan was well over the top. So on paper and in practice, a reasonably straightforward job this for Ottke.
Good job.
Of course, Randy Newman used to fight as a heavyweight. As I say, he once boxed a British referee, my old mate, Billy Aird. Of course, that match wouldn't be allowed today because Billy Aird is a wee bit heavier than Randy Newman. Well, now you can see that Butler has completely run out of ideas. He's reactive instead of proactive. And he'll try anything, because nothing so far has worked. And Ottke has absolutely wrapped him up. And he's just putting the finishing touches to this little parcel that used to be James Butler's challenge for the IBF super middleweight title. Popping back in the post, back to Harlem. Empty-handed, of course. Awfully frustrating for Butler. Nothing major getting through, not really getting battered by anything, but, you know, just getting beaten. All hands down in every department. And there you are again, another round for Sven Ottke.
Is Drive. It's a 4-CD set with the 60 most exhilarating open-air tracks ever written. With classic artists like Eric Clapton, Jonathan Vangelis, Fleetwood Mac, The Christians and Christopher. It just hits the road and keeps going.
My name is Luca.
But you can't buy it in the shops. You have to order by phone. To get your copy, call now. Inside, we know great music when we hear it.
Boxing. With Hasseröder, the German Premier beer.
So let's go into round 8. And who'd want to be James Butler? Absolutely mastered in every single department. And I don't believe he carries sort of one-punch knockout power. He's scored 4 or 5 clean knockouts, but at an entirely different level to this. And that's always important, you know, when you consider the outcome of a boxing match. You've got to consider the class they've actually been performing in. Ottke's has been consistently higher than Butler's. It's not Butler's fault, of course. His opportunities come along, and he's had to say yes. You don't often get this this chance. But what it means is, if Butler is as beatable as Ottke's making him look, it means Butler will get another chance at a world title. Everyone likes a game loser. Still, the silver foil flutters down into the ring. Not that Ottke needs any more sparkle added to his performance so far. And once again, another change of tactics here by Butler. And look what good it did him. Ottke is a mercurial sort. He'll change, he'll bend, he'll sway, just to keep on top. Good left hook. And we don't often see Ottke landing hard shots. He doesn't really possess that kind of power. But a decent left hook there, I thought. And of course, the other major advantage that the Germans have is they have this 24-foot ring. It's enormous. Anyone who wants a fight will not get it in a German ring this size. There's an old saying, you can run but you can't hide, but sometimes I beg to differ, especially in the case of a ring this big. I think it's 24 foot on the inside perimeter. I'll have to check with Mike Goodall, but very, very hard to pin anyone down in the ring this big, especially someone as deft as Ottke, who wins yet another round. That's 8 on the trot, in my opinion. That's 80 points now against 72.
Das wird nochmal jetzt versuchen. Ja. Er geht das Risiko jetzt ein. Ja. Du musst stehen wie ein Goldberg.
Ja.
Gut. Gut. So, wie ein Bollwerk. Schön stehen. Sven, dann höre zu. Geh ruhig ein bisschen weiter weg, dass er noch hinterherkommt und das aufbauen muss, ja? Machst du gut so. Die Führung ist klasse. Aber zurück, zieh da oben. Aber nach oben zurück.
So, touch of replay here. Bit of desperation there. For Butler. And there's a very paternal kind of attitude from Uli Wegner with Sven Ottke. They've been together an awful long time. I think since Ottke was 9 years of age. And that's 25 years. I mean, that's a long time. That's a father-son relationship, isn't it? And of course, Wegner, the most successful trainer so far in the history of German boxing. He's had his dark moments too, of course. Once again, decent boxing here from Ottke. Just pokes out the jab, keeps Butler busy. And while Butler's thinking about that left hand, of course, and what to do about it, he's not doing anything else himself. My answer would be a right hand over the top, but of course, it's trying to calculate just exactly where. Oh, that was naughty. Don't like to see that. Do not like to see that in a boxing ring. And he's very fortunate he didn't have a point deducted there. Could well have done. Naughty. Don't like to see infringements like that. It's hard enough trying to fend off the punches, let alone anything else. Yes, as I was saying, it's awfully hard to anticipate just exactly when Ottke is going to throw that left hand. So, you know, you've got to be incredibly quick or lucky to pop him over the top with the right. And Butler now doing what so many previous opponents have done. He's accepting defeat. He's capitulated mentally. There's no doubt about it, Ottke is a very, very good technician. And it all comes from decent footwork. You've only got to look back at the great fighters in the past. Their footwork was superb. And once again, around to Svenny. As they call him, nine on the spin now.
Jetzt ganz klug boxen. Ja. Keine Blöße, keine Blöße geben. Er weiß nie, wie es aussieht. Ja. So ist es gut, wie du es machst. Machst du gar nichts.
Once more, this is that infringement by hard punch on the back of the neck there. As I say, it's tough enough when the punches come straight at you, but you don't expect them round the back of the neck as well. Well, you should. It's a boxing ring after all, and desperate men, desperate measures. Round 10. It's the home straight now. And Ottke, barring accidents, looks well on his way to winning for the 24th. Consecutive time, and of course retaining his world title for the 11th successive occasion. I've got to say, this is also a learning experience, I think, for Butler. I'm not sure what benefit it might do him, but, you know, he's only 28 years of age. He's by no means at the scrap heap stage. But, I mean, this will do one of two things. It will enhance his ability, or it will give him nightmares. You know, it'll break him up, it'll break his heart. I don't know. I don't know how he's going to react. Just got to keep an eye out for him, I suppose, and see how he does next time out. He's never the same after this kind of systematic beating. Not that it's a painful one, don't get me wrong. You know, Ottke's not a punishing sort, but he messes with your mind, that's the problem. This is also the stage when Ottke knows he's a mile in front and won't try anything too drastic and too risky. He'll just be quite content to stay there. Yeah, this is a nullifying stage now for Ottke. He's going to prevent Butler from doing anything potentially dangerous. And once again, just contains the challenger. Two rounds to go. Ottke a mile in front. Got him winning all 10 for 100 points to 90. And Don Turner, I always find a very surly character whenever I bump into him. One of those characters, I think anyway, who claims all the plaudits when he has a successful fighter, although he might not have done all the work. He doesn't seem to want to take a great deal of credit when they don't perform.
Get that grease out of his hair.
Doesn't smile a great deal either. Yes, penultimate round then. Round 11 here of the scheduled 12 IBF Super Middleweight Championship. Very firmly in the grasp of the German Sven Ottke. And James Butler has yet to prise those fingers open. And you wouldn't actively go looking to fight Ottke, would you? You'd only take the job because it was available. That's for not any other reason. I don't have a single fighter out there who actually wants to take on Ottke. He's just too tricky. And maybe that is the reason that the likes of Butler turn up in the opposite corner to face Ottke, because there's no genuine fighters out there want any part of him. So they've got to start casting their net a bit wider. And of course it's increasingly difficult to beat Ottke on German soil. Although the judges are neutral, in essence. Well, Butler still trying his arm here as a southpaw. And Ottke really, and that's another thing he does well, he moans well. He can moan for Germany, Ottke. He's got this way about him, gets referees on his side, moans about the slightest little thing. But it works. Well, see now what's happened. The crowd now have taken to Ottke's cause. Any sign of an infringement by Butler, and they're going to be giving the whistle. They're very loyal, these German supporters. Decent jab there. First time that I think Butler's landed a decent jab to knock the head of Ottke back. Too wild with the follow-up. But then again, what else could he do? So he's trying to work him out, and it hasn't got a clue what to do. You can see it written all over his face. And there you are. Too late now for anything else. Ottke winning by a mile. This has got to be 12-0, isn't it?
Die letzte Runde ist ganz stabil weiter so boxen. Ja. Versucht jetzt immer so normal.
Stick to your boxing, don't make any mistakes in the final round is a fairly loose translation, I think, of what Uli Wegner was saying there.
Okay, yeah, Rudi.
Wasser.
Mundschutz, Mensch.
Schon in Ruhe, Trainer, bleib mal locker.
Mundschutz, Mensch, er soll das richtig abdrücken.
I really do. I'm one of those guys. I used to hate a big wad of Vaseline on my face. Very uncomfortable. I don't know if you've, those of you who never had Vaseline, if you go in the bathroom and bug a bit of Vaseline on your face, it's
see how it feels. Around your eyes or your nose, very uncomfortable. Here we go then, 12th and final round. And barring major mistakes and acts of God here, there's no way that Butler's taking this belt back to New York. Ooh, long left hook, catching Ottke. Sven does the right thing, though, and then suddenly does the wrong thing for one of the very few times in his career. And Butler going absolutely berserk here. You've got to stay on top. Got to stay in charge. Got to keep that focus. And even resort to this, if need be. Oh! But Randy Newman has taken a point off Butler's scorecard. I don't know what for. It was Ottke who committed the infringement. He put him in a headlock. See, once again, Ottke, incredibly clever. He knows how to manipulate referees and the crowd. But most of all, he knows how to master opponents. But as I say, there's going to come a time when it all disappears. And Ottke is left wondering where it all went wrong. That's if he stays around too long. And just when you thought it would just go settling down to a sedentary finish, we've got a war on our hands. And of course, it's Butler's only chance is to draw Ottke into a punch-up. And this is the... Oh, good right from Ottke. This is the area that Lloyd Bryan had his moments. He did really rough Ottke up and stayed on top of him. Ottke didn't fight his normal fight on that occasion, but still, I think, came through on merit to retain, like he's going to do here. No doubt about it, Butler's having his moments in this final round, but it's going to cost him, because of that deduction by the referee. It's going to be a two-point round, this one, I think. And again, good footwork from Ottke. Glides out of the way, sometimes has to dive out of the way. Crowd on their feet now, cheering the hero home as the bell ends 12 rounds of boxing, with Ottke surely retaining his IBF super middleweight crown, and that last round finishing 10-8. Well, 120-107 on my card, courtesy of course of that extra point deduction in the final round. We'll wait and see what the judges say. And whilst, of course, as I said before, the IBF allow Ottke, not that it's anything really to do with them, it's not really their fault, you know. If the challengers aren't out there, you can't fight them. Well, he's a very happy man, isn't he? Work hard for that win. Lars Riedel, of course, the celebrity Olympic champion, MC for this one. Well, almost a bit of respect, I think, from that American corner there. There's our matchmaker, Jean-Marcel Nartz. Got to look beyond the Czech Republic, Jean-Marcel, for opponents. So the official scorecards then being counted up. And we'll very shortly get the official verdict. Here we go. Goodness me, she gave 2 points against Sven Ottke, two rounds against Ottke. Unbelievable. Well, that's interesting. One round against Ottke as well. And again, one of the judges there giving two rounds against Sven Ottke. And I'd like to know which two rounds he lost. Maybe the first and last, who knows? But no doubt about it, Ottke, a unanimous points winner, retains his IBF title for the 11th straight time, and did it in style as well. There you go. Still the Weltmeister.